The discoveries of Dr. C. Ronald Kahn have been central to forming our understanding of the mechanisms of diabetes. At the 2013 Joslin International Symposium on Diabetes, researchers from around the world have traveled to Boston to talk about their own research and to honor the man who has made such tremendous contributions to the fight against diabetes. We spoke to Dr. Kahn about his career, his discoveries, and what he sees as the future of diabetes research.
I came from a family where my father was a merchant, but my brother was really interested in science. He was an older brother. And he got me interested in doing research. Actually, at a very young age, I started doing research in college quite a lot, did research through medical school. And then the real important turning point in my career was when I went to the National Institutes of Health. That was 1970, and I joined the laboratory of Jesse Roth and Phil Gordon, who were really pioneering new ways to think about diabetes research. And it was a very exciting time. And I think that the atmosphere there, the creativity of not only these two leaders, but the people who were coming to work with them, who became leaders in many places around the world, really inspired me to see the excitement of this field. This, of course, then led eventually to my coming to Joslin in 1981, where I got to develop here my own group of researchers and to bring other people in who would complement my interest with interest in type 1 diabetes, type 2, metabolism, islet cell physiology, complications of diabetes. And this has been a very stimulating career for me. And I'm still very stimulated by the research. One of the things that's been particularly exciting about having research as a career is that you can follow a problem that is interesting and challenging in many different directions. Diabetes is a complicated disease. It's not just a single disease. We know that there's type 1 and type 2 diabetes, and we know that there are, of course, complications of diabetes, but each of these has many aspects. And one of the things that I find most exciting personally about doing research is to pursue new aspects and new directions, to follow those leads in different ways, and to try to do it in a way that ultimately I think I can bring together a picture of diabetes and its pathophysiology, its cause, if you will, in a way that wouldn't be possible if I only focused in a single track. For me, the ultimate goal of all of this is not just a cure. I say that in a way that somebody may think I'm taking this lightly, but I think a cure is not enough. Really what we would like is prevention. What we'd really like to do is to keep people from getting type 1 diabetes, type 2 diabetes, or any of the complications from the very beginning. And so what's so important about understanding how these diseases progress in these basic pathways is that it does give us that opportunity, or eventually it will give us that opportunity, because we'll know what's going on before. We now know that type 1 diabetes starts as an autoimmune disease many years before people actually lose beta cell function and develop clinical symptoms. That's when we should try to block it. We know that type 2 diabetes starts as insulin resistance many years before the people develop any abnormalities of glucose function. We know we can reverse this to a large extent in many people by weight loss and exercise, at least temporarily. But that doesn't seem to be a long-term fix for everybody, in part because it's hard to do. But that's where we need to block it. And we know that in individuals who are developing diabetes, that certain individuals are more prone to develop complications than others. We don't know exactly why. We don't know what the genetics or the factors are that contribute to this. But if we did, then we should try to block those as well. So if somebody does develop diabetes, we're not only treating the blood sugar or the metabolic abnormalities, but we're really treating the things that make people with diabetes suffer most with their disease, which is the risk of long-term complications. So I'm optimistic about all of these things, actually, but it will take work, and I think that we have to realize that we have a long way still to go, even though we've made tremendous progress. I think that the biggest obstacle in research in general is lack of imagination. One of the challenges for all scientists in every field is to try to think outside the box. We learn about classical pathways that are written in textbooks and taught in school. And we read articles and we say, oh, this has been proven, this has been shown in a way that we don't need to look any further at this. And almost always that's wrong. Almost always there's more to the story if we look at it more deeply. And so what I would say is that of course we have challenges with funding and we have challenges of other sorts, but I think that as an investigator, the most important advice I try to give my own fellows is to try to think ahead, to think creatively, to think about what will make the biggest impact in terms of a discovery, not only because you'll get a nice publication, but because it'll have a big impact in the field. And that impact in the field will eventually add up through with other impacts to lead to new treatments and new preventions for diabetes and its complications.